Hello everyone and welcome back to the Palace Zoo. It's been 2 weeks, so that's not too bad. New record for like the last 6 months. But yeah, what are we gonna do this episode? We're gonna enlarge this elephant habitat first, because I've received some advice from some people in the Discord that the elephant habitat is a bit too small. And the design is fine, it's all fine, it's just they need more space. So I made a little small section here, which I actually reserved for the rhinos. But I decided the elephants are just gonna have more space, and then the rhinos we can save for another zoo or whatever, I don't know. I decided to make it eye level to have more respect for the animals, another tip I got. Because in the other section is like a pit you look down to. So yeah, now they're like at the same level as humans, so that's good for them, I guess. And so I extended the little path thing here. You say how I did that? I just made a circle and filled up the middle and then connected them. That's one way to make a plaza if you need specific borders like this. But yeah, then I covered it up. I still need to make something on this square, and I don't quite know which or what I want to have here. So if you guys have any tips, let me know. And then of course I needed to build the wall here, and I started with a very rudimentary set of rocks to rock out the habitat. That's gonna be where all the elephants are going up here on the ramp. And same deal as the other part of the habitat. This walkway you see in the middle here, not anymore, it's gonna be blocked off. It's gonna be just a viewing area now. I didn't want to make a bridge, just didn't look right, and it just would mess up the whole concept. So now here is a little pond between the guest and the elephants. I don't know quite why, but I saw it in a lot of pictures and I thought it looked well, so why not, you know? Let's do it. And more rocks? Yep, not that interesting. Let me talk about what we're also adding this episode. A monorail, yeah. A monorail for guests to go around the zoo. It's like a little park monorail, it's not like the big Disney ones. Or like, it's more meant as a scenic view ride, as well as a transport ride. There are two stations. And the first station is going to be in the location you'll see in a bit. But the second station is going to be in the Asian section of the zoo that isn't quite there yet. So yeah, that's going to be exciting. Now for the outer wall of the elephant habitat, I decided to go with the wall I also used in the previous video, of like a copper topping on a limestone wall. And I thought it was nice for the zoo, and why not use it more to round it off a bit. So we can start finishing this zoo, because we're all quite far ahead. There's only like a safari to add now, which is like an episode, really fun. There's like pandas we need to add, and then like a temple for monkeys or jaguars, I'm not quite sure yet. I'm not gonna make an ape house, probably too much work, and I want to reserve that for another zoo. And then maybe a little park area to the left side of the zoo, the west angle. But yeah, some more rocks and dead trees here. And I really like these sticky things. I think they just make it a bit more prettier, and they make like a fake gate thing as well. And I put some benches here for people to see either way, because some people may like the water and the fountain more than the elephants. How dare they? I don't know. But, you know, something for everyone. Then I took this like sunshade from the Lion Theater thing and put them here. I don't know quite if it's big enough or whatever, but I thought it looked nice. But if there's something wrong with this, let me know. Then I'll fix it, or just go delete it completely. I don't know. I'm not an animal expert. I probably should do a bit more research, but I just don't know as much about zoos as theme parks or something. But yeah, so here starts the construction of the monorail station. And first off, I had like a little African hut here, because I wanted the safari ride to be African themed, but it didn't fit at all with the terrace you see here, the Greek thing. So I got rid of that. I recorded it, but I lost the recording, so that's kinda, well, not, it doesn't really matter. doesn't matter. But anyway, I'm reconstructing the layout of the monorail, and it goes very much around the inside borders of the zoo, and then one small section outside of it to go back into the station. And it, like, the shape of it is very nice to look at from the entrance. You see sometimes like a car going by, and it makes the zoo feel more alive. Also because I don't have any guests in the zoo at the moment, for frame rate reasons, and well, I need to optimize it as well with all the management stuff. The management stuff is a mess. I got like 50 notifications of stuff going wrong in the zoo. So yeah, that's gonna be like one or two episodes at least to fix all the management stuff, the keeper huts. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. It's gonna be interesting. So I'm making the path layout for the monorail station, and it's pretty high up. But I made like a slanted path here instead of stairs, so wheelchairs can get up it as well. That's very important, of course. I like to keep it a bit realistic. It is a bit steep, but oh well. That's what they're gonna get. So limestone building, people, again, back to the roots of the zoo. I felt like doing that, and also just made like a baroque building in Planet Coaster. You'll see next week, hopefully. Watch it. Yes, good. And some small stairs here, pretty self-explanatory stuff. Just a little queue, doesn't need to be too long. I mean, it's a monorail, it's not the biggest roller coaster or anything. Talking about roller coasters, wouldn't it be great if we got some little flat rides in the game, like a carousel or like a small caterpillar coaster, some stuff to just make the game a bit more variety in the zoo. Of course, if you're really into animals, there's plenty of you to see. But if you're more into, well, not theme parks, but I don't know, just general things. I'm a theme park geek. I want to see flat lights, and I know this isn't the game for that, maybe. But it will. Well, you do see a lot of zoos with like little rides here and there, like safari rides, whatever. Even big theme parks combined with zoos. Like what is it called? Animal Kingdom is there in Florida, and also in Florida is Busch Gardens Tampa is also a zoo, and in Sweden they have Kolmården. I don't know how to pronounce it, but it is a pretty sweet zoo, and they've got one of the best roller coasters as well. So of course, that's like an ancient suggestion, not really complained by the. Mostly the Planet Coaster community, that they just wanted to be able to add animals into their parks. But I think they really made the right choice making it a separate game. It's more focused on conservation and preservation of animal species instead of the entertainment of guests necessarily. So I get why they wouldn't add really that kind of stuff in here as well. It makes me excited about Planko 2, that we might have weather effects and things like that. Here I'm making some pillars, and these pillars are going up. I saw like a reference images on Google, and it didn't look like this entirely, but it had interesting shapes. So I thought, why not Google it? Use it. Also, I copied these windows in a weird way. I used it the same on the palace in the first episode, but this is a way to enlarge them a bit because they're quite small by themselves, and I want a bit of a larger window. Then I use these trimmings to make it more interesting, and slowly but surely a more interesting building starts to shape up. Talking about the zoo, right? Like, what would you guys to see next episode? Of course, we got the safari ride going up, but I'm not entirely sure what kind of station I want to do. I do actually. I got the suggestion of making like an old horse race stadium or stables for the safari ride to be. That would really fit the theme of the zoo, so I'm probably gonna go for that. So I'm gonna do a bit of research into that. If anyone has any cool ideas for animals, stuff like that, let me know, then I can take a look and put it in here. And then for the gardens, like in the later episodes, the gardens are gonna be like, we have the royal gardens now behind the palace here. But I want that to be extended to the left, like a little canyon, not really canyon, but like a little hillside thing, like Alton Towers have in their park. I mean, it's a theme park, but they have these lovely gardens in a valley with lots of little architecture buildings. I've never walked there. I went there twice now to Alton Towers, but really, we didn't really walk through the gardens. It's pretty big as well. So, oh well, there's enough pictures online probably. Yeah, I'm excited to work on that. And then I've got a big decision to make on whether I want monkeys in the in the South American section of the zoo. If I want a monkey temple or a jaguar temple. Now, someone already suggested a jaguar temple, but that will mean we don't have any monkeys at all in the zoo. So, thinking. Maybe both, but then I don't really know how to theme each enclosure, because one is then a temple, but what's the other one gonna be? I don't know, maybe it can just be one giant temple separated into two habitats. We'll have to see. And then the panda habitat as well. I'm not sure if we're gonna go full on with the Asian theming, or just more like this limestone stuff. We'll have to see about that, whatever people would like to see. And meanwhile, the building is still being constructed. It isn't really exciting to watch this, and I wasn't feeling it for the first part of building it, but then I restarted this morning. Not really restarted, I came back to it, and I just felt in a better mood, and I felt more like playing this game. So yeah. So yeah, what have you guys been up to this week, eh? I want a bit more interactivity with the people. I love responding to you guys. If you have any suggestions of stuff, let me know. Click that subscribe button and the notification bell thing. Ding dong dong ding 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 ding. I ask that every episode, of course. But I mean, that's the way it is, I guess. I'm really grateful for everyone who likes to watch these videos. I really enjoy doing it again. And I'm getting a new computer, so I can play the games more effortlessly. Because I'm having a lot of frame rate issues and stuff. That's going to be a big investment. But I'm looking forward to it with all the new cards coming out now and the new processor soon. It's going to be a fun time. I might get into Assassin's Creed even back again and into the new one. But I don't know. I don't know how many people are going to watch that. It doesn't matter. We're in a palace zoo now. That's what matters, right? Yes, the palace zoo. Excited to finish it, what I said before. There isn't really anything to say about this build. It's just limestone with some, more limestone details, blah, 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 blah. It's very self-explanatory. So I could have cut it out of, me building this, but some people like to see how they build it, right? I mean, that's what the time-lapse is for as well. Also, do you guys like this sort of format of time lapse, or do you maybe want to see more like a cinematic format where I just walk through the zoo in real time, or more like a cinematic style like I do before and the end of these videos but longer? Or do you think the format is fine? Because I try to make I'm looking for ways to make the videos more interesting, because I'm doing it for a year now, and we already got up to 3,000 subscribers in a year. Isn't that great? It's amazing. Thanks for all the subscribers, but I'm really trying to think, what makes the video, what could make the videos more interesting for people? Do you like long videos or short videos or intermediate videos? I never try to go about 20 minutes, because then I really feel, in a time-lapse form at least, that it's too long. I might just do 5-minute videos with just a tour, where I explain it a bit more, it's a bit more fun to watch, I don't know, or people think differently about that, eh? It's a difficult thing. I always try to improve the channel a bit, and of course some people like things more than others, and other way around. Yeah, that's just how it is. Anyway, here's an air vent. What do air vents do? They suck up the air, I guess. No, do they? They filter the air. I'm not sure. I'm not an air ventiologist. I'm not a zoologist either. Maybe I should be. Doesn't seem like a good idea. Anyway, some rocky rocks and some more rocky rocks. Because, well, what do you need more life than limestone? Normal stone. Right, okay. More trees. More reeds. Wow. That was the video. It's a cool little building. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you think, of course. See you guys next time. Bye! Thank you.